بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا إنك سميع مجيب الدعاء. اللهم إني أعوذ بك من علم لا ينفع وقلب لا يخشع ونفس لا تشبع ودعاء لا يسمع. ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب. ربي اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. السلام عليكم everyone, welcome back again. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. This is our Tuesday night program and this will be the last one as this is the last Tuesday in Sha'ban. Allah knows, but Ramadan could be Saturday or Sunday. We will know Friday, bi-idhnillah. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the dua that we all have to continue to keep asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He will give us life, Ya Rabbi Ameen, till we get to Ramadan. Yes, there is only 3-4 days left, but we don't know. Allahumma balighna Ramadan, Allahumma barik lana fi Ramadan, Allahumma balighna Ramadan, Allahumma barik lana fi Ramadan. Ya Allah, give us life till we live to Ramadan. So till Saturday or Sunday, and then barik lana fi Ramadan. That all these 30 days, 29 days, again, Allah knows how long, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put barakah in our time. And the first thing I want to focus on, to put it as a goal, in general in life, there is always goals. What do I want to do? And I think to welcome Ramadan wholeheartedly, sincerely, is I need to say to myself, what do I want to get at the end of Ramadan? What is my goal? And everybody, all the Muslims, walillahi alhamdu wal minna, those who can, will fast. A good number of them will go to Taraweeh or they will pray in the house, they will pray extra. What is my goal? And this is the first thing in the next 3 days, I have to keep reminding myself and I need to put a goal. What do I want to do in the Ramadan? One, what are my goals? If I'm going to put R, what are my goals at the end of Ramadan? So the first day of Eid or the night of Eid, if I look at the list I made it today, did I check it? Did I did that? 1, 2, and 3, and 4. And I'm going to maybe cover a couple of them. And again, we are different human beings. We have different circumstances. But definitely put a good goal for yourself. The goal that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put it for all of us to start with is what? يا أيها الذين آمنوا كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم. Why? لعلكم تتقون. Oh you believer, يا أيها الذين آمنوا, believers, you and me. طيب, كتب عليكم الصيام. This is the verse that you all know بإذن الله, and you all gonna hear it again and again. It's in Surah Al-Baqarah, in the cow chapter of the cow, second chapter in the Quran. يا أيها الذين آمنوا, oh believer, you, oh you who attain faith, what? كتب عليكم الصيام. Anytime as Ramadan is coming, when you hear يا أيها الذين آمنوا, O you believers, O you who believe, as Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Mas'ud used to say, أرعيها سمعك, give it good listen, meaning listen well, pay attention. Allah is speaking to you and me. You know, like the Quran has many things. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is teaching us. There is history. There is about Him subhanahu, about this life, about the hereafter. But when He say, يا أيها الذين آمنوا, this is a specific, direct communication between Him subhanahu to me and to you. And I need to know, what is He telling me? What does He want to tell me? Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu. What is it, Ya Allah? Here I am, I'm ready. Tell me. Kutiba alaykum as-siyam. Number one, fasting became an obligation. Now, fasting is an obligation. Okay? Kama kutiba ala alladhina min qablikum. As it has been obligation on the people before you. Okay, what is the goal? لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. So you may attain taqwa. Everybody. So my goal and your goal at the end of Ramadan And this is how I am going to welcome Ramadan with this goal. Istaqwa. La'allakum tattaqoon. So you may gain taqwa. طيب, what is taqwa? What is taqwa? Taqwa is translated in many ways. I personally love this. Taqwa is Allah conscious. Taqwa is Allah conscious. Now, me being Allah conscious, you are Allah conscious, we are all Allah conscious. It doesn't mean Allah conscious when I am in the masjid only. It doesn't mean I am Allah conscious when I am fasting only. It doesn't mean I am muttaqi, Allah conscious, when I started my siyam, my fasting, or when I ended my siyam, my fasting, or when I am in tarawih, or when I am reading Quran. No. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. It's general. Throughout the whole day and the night, as I am going to sleep, what keep should stay in my mind and keep reminding myself, don't remind anybody. I need to be remembered first. I cannot remind you unless I remind myself first. And my reminder and your reminder will not bring fruit unless I practice it. As one of the righteous people says, العلم يهتف بالعمل. Knowledge call for actions, otherwise action will leave. Meaning, if I only learn and I don't practice it, and you don't practice it, you know what? Even that knowledge will leave because it's not bringing fruit. So, لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. Taqwa. What is taqwa? What is taqwa? And we really need to define it in a way practical. So I know, am I at this moment muttaqi, at that moment muttaqi? Allah conscious means I am all the time aware that Allah is with me, listening to me, seeing me, and will ask me. All the time, Allah is with me, and that's very good because I need this. I need this strength. If Allah is with me and Allah is with you, how strong I am? Who can make me weaker? Keep reminding myself, Allah is with me. كَلَّا إِنَّ مَعِيَ رَبِّي سَيَهْدِينَ. As Sayyidina Musa said when he was running, he and the people who just believed in him ran away from Pharaoh. And the people who believed with Sayyidina Musa looked back and saw Fir'aun behind. And they said, قَالُوا إِنَّا لَمُدْرَكُونَ. That's it. They're going to catch us. They are just behind us. And he immediately said, كَلَّا نَي. Look at that moment. Moment of fear, moment of test and trial. And immediately, because he lived with it, with Allah is with me, he said, كَلَّا نَي إِنَّ مَعِيَ رَبِّي سَيَهْدِينَ. My Lord is with me. He's going to guide me. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. Throughout the day. And we need now, from now, 3-4 days, keep reminding myself. I need to bring a reminder for myself. Even I send reminder for myself through my phone. Is what? Inna ma'iya Rabbi. Number one, Allah is with me. The fact Allah is with me, subhanah, specifically, meaning I will not go astray. He will help me. He will guide me. But at the same time, he's looking at me. I need to keep reminding myself. So the way I drink, the way I break my fast, the way I stand up for salah, the way I deal with other people, the way I respond to people, that's all Allah is watching. Allah ma'i, but Allah is also seeing me, right? So Allah is with me. Allah is seeing me. Allah is hearing me. And Allah will ask me. Then I am a muttaqi. If I apply this, now you're going to tell me this is very difficult. I'm going to say this is very hard. But at least I start with a point. And if I cannot get it all, that doesn't mean I'm going to leave it all. At least I start. I start with myself from the morning to the evening that it's Ramadan. It is supposed to burn all my sins, as we said last week. And I am fasting, not because everybody else is fasting, not because it's an obligation, but that's the superficial. The deeper one is لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. So I will be the abd, the servant, that when Allah look at me, or He's looking at me and looking at you, He's so pleased. What is taqwa? How did people, the scholars and the righteous people, defined it? And I'm going to give you some definitions and then we'll apply it practically, right? Talq ibn Habib, he said, At-taqwa, an ta'amal bi nuri Allah. An ta'amal bi ta'ati Allah ala nuri min Allah tarju thawab Allah. Taqwa is you act by the obedience of Allah. And I'll give some practical example. I act, you act by the obedience of Allah. عَلَى نُورٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ, based upon what He said, not what I like and you like and what everybody else is doing. And why I'm doing it, تَرَجُوا ثَوَابَ اللَّهِ, the only reason I'm doing it, for no other reason, but for Allah to reward me. وَأَن تَتْرُكْ مَعْصِيَةَ اللَّهِ, and you stay away from the disobedience of Allah. عَلَى نُورٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ, based upon what He said. مَخَافَةَ عِقَابِ اللَّهِ, you're afraid of His punishment. Let's apply this in my daily life, in Ramadan, right? I act by the obedience, according to what He told me to do. What did He tell me to do? Fast, meaning, externally, I'm not going to eat from morning, from dusk to dawn. طيب. And who said that? عَلَى نُورٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ. It's in the Quran and in the Sunnah. And why? Why? That's the sincerity. That's the ikhlas. For no other reason. For no other reason. Other than He will reward me. So when I and you in front of Him, and He's opening the book, the book of Sarah, of Muhammad, of Abdullah, of Haifa, of anyone, right? He will open the book and He will see. And He knows, subhanah, that on that day, April 2nd, April 3rd, I and you and us, we all fasted for only one reason. Why? I need my reward, Ya Rabbi. Reward me, Allah. And that is why Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam, in this famous hadith, reported by Sayyidina Abu Huraira in many version of it, من صام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. You're going to hear this hadith very frequently. من صام رمضان, whomsoever fasted Ramadan, but not just fasted Ramadan, إيمانا واحتسابا, as a believer and a full belief, is that what he needs to do or she needs to do? And what? احتسابا, I am looking for my reward, and I know Allah will reward me. So I come in the morning, before I even started the fasting yet, I come with this. I know He will reward me. What will happen? غُفِرَ لَهُ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِهِ. Subhanallah, think of this hadith. غُفِرَ لَهُ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِهِ. That person, she or he, sins before, will be completely removed, wiped, expiated. And in another version, man sama wa Ramadan wa qama Ramadan. You fasted and you prayed, or you spend the night of Ramadan in salah, qiyam, standing, meaning in prayer. So taqwa, again, we're going to go back. Taqwa, I act by the obedience of Allah, based upon what He told me. And I only want the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Only, no other reason. So, when someone come and irritate me, say something that bothers me for no reason, immediately comes to me, لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. You're fasting. That's why Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam said, إِذَا كَانَ صَوْمُ يَوْمِ أَحَدْكُمْ. If someone is fasting, right? And someone, فَإِذَا سَبَّهُ أَوْ شَتَمَهُ أَحَدٍ, if someone come and irritated you, got angry and said things that is curse you basically, فَلْيَقُلْ إِنِّي صَائِمٍ, let him say or she, I am fasting. What is that? That's the obedience of Allah. based upon what he taught me alayhi salatu wasalam. And why? Because I want my reward, Ya Allah. When I meet you, Ya Rabbi, I want my reward. I want my reward because I was a muttaqi in that moment. When I stand up in Taraweeh, in Salah, whether in the house, whether in the masjid, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. This is the first Ramadan after 2 years of two Ramadan where things are back to normal. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Taraweeh are open, masajids are all open, there's no social distance, Mecca walillah alhamd is open, Umrah is open, Medina is open, Aqsa is open, all the masajids are open. How grateful I am going to be. How grateful I am to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How grateful I am to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Least I am going to be is I am going to act as a muttaqi, grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We talked about this last week for gratefulness. But today we're going to focus on this. So here I am, the moment of breaking my fast. The goal, لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. Prepare wholeheartedly, work on my taqwa. And if I can do it for 30 days, and بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ, by his help, I will be able to do it after all. So here I am, coming to break my fast. Is breaking my fast ala ta'atillah, is it something pleasing to Allah? Na'am, he told me. Actually, what the Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam told me is like, it is highly recommended to break your fast quickly. Don't delay it. Don't delay it. So I picked up the date, or if I don't have a date, I got the water, or whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allowed me. Sunnah is on the date, but could be I am in a place or working and I don't have it. Doesn't matter. So I'm breaking my fast. Why? Because he told me. That's the ta'ah. Now, how I am breaking the fast, I need to remember this. What is the most pleasing way of breaking my fast to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? The way Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam did. Dates, if I have it, right? And if I don't, on the water, gentle. And then I make the dua. I make the supplication. Especially when you're drinking the water, what are you going to say, right? ذهب الظما وابتلت العروق وثبت الأجر إن شاء الله. The thirst has been extinguished, right? And the veins are wet because the water is coming. And the أجر, the reward, has been recorded. So I say this. See, it's a simple things. We don't need to look of taqwa. Major thing. I can't be these people who are muttaqi. Where am I from them? No. Let's take it simple. Simple things that we're going to be doing it on daily basis in Ramadan. I'm going to take you through that. So when I am breaking my fast, is that a ta'a? Is that an act of obedience? Yes. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Now, the way I do it has to be also an act of obedience. So I am going to do it with a dua. Gentle. I feel it. One. Why I'm doing this? Because that's what he told me, alayhi salatu wasalam. And actually, the timing, Allah told me. فَكُلُوا وَشَرَبُوا حَتَّى يَتَبَيْنَ لَكُمُ الْخَيْطُ الْأَبْيَطُ مِنَ الْخَيْطِ الْأَسْوَدِ مِنَ الْفَجْرِ ثُمَّ أَتُمُّ الصِّيَامَ إِلَى اللَّيْلِ. That's the verse in Surah Al-Baqarah. Eat till you know that we talked about it last time, the dark from the white line, basically. These days, alhamdulillah, we have it all in our phones. And then, atimmu siyam, don't eat and drink till the night, sunset. So I did it based on what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala taught me and what Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam taught me. Three, the most important thing. We really need to remind ourselves of this, because sometimes what happens, we do things for casual. And not only casual, we do it as a casual, but the reason we do it as casual, because it became a habit. I don't look at it as an act of worship, deep. Deep is an act of worship. The most beloved, I just finished the most beloved act to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. On daily basis, imagine if we remember this. I just did an act of worship that is for Allah only. As-sawm li wa ana ajzi bih. Fasting is for me and I reward by it. So this is how it is. And ta'bud Allah. And ta'bud Allah. And ta'bud ala ta'atillah. Ala nurin min Allah. Tarju thawab Allah. You do an act of worship based on the light from Allah, Al-Quran and Sunnah, and you are looking for the reward. And the opposite, this is half taqwa. This is only half taqwa. I can't be a muttaqi. And again, we're going to speak practically. It's only 3-4 days left. I can't be a muttaqi. And I can't be, I want la'allakum tattaqun day 30. And the moment I break my fast and eat, the next thing I am going to do, I'm going to do disobedience to Allah. Whether in my tongue, whether in my ear, whether in my eyes, I start looking at this and that, or I start listening to this and that, or I start eating this and that that is not pleasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then that's a 50% taqwa only in the morning. And then the goal is not being achieved. It's like somebody, they want to lose weight, and they told them, you need to be, let's say, on this amount of calorie. And you have to do that much of exercise to reach your goal. And guess what? I do half and half, and my goal will be half. And when I'm in front of Allah, I will get only 50%. So do based on looking for. Do the acts of worship. Looking based on what Allah told me. And looking for my reward. And I stay away from the disobedience of Allah based upon what He told me, not what people say, what He told me. And I'm looking for my reward. I say this all the time to my beautiful sisters who get their menstruation during Ramadan. And the sisters feel really sad, and I feel it. And I know their feeling. But my answer to everybody, why are you fasting? The first thing when the woman asked me, I was like Sister Haifa, why can't I fast? I really love fasting. And my answer is, why do you want to fast? Because it's something Allah told me to do. It's not because everybody is fasting. It's easier, for sure, when everybody else is fasting. But I am fasting because He told me to. شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن هدى للناس وبينات من الفرقان والهدى فمن شهد منكم وبينات من الهدى والفرقان فمن شهد منكم الشهر فليصم. Whomsoever live or see the moon of the month, let them fast. So I am doing it to please Allah. Then I come and I say to this sister, and this is for all the sisters listening to me, what does He want me to do when the woman is during that time of the month? Not to fast. Then I am muttaqi, because I stayed away from something He told me not to do, although it is an act of worship. But He told me not to fast. Then sami'na wa ata'na, I hear and obey. And this is based upon al-Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam, what he said, what he told us. And I am looking for my reward. This is extremely important for the sisters. When I don't fast in Ramadan, I will be rewarded the same way that person who fasted. Why? Because these both are acts of worship. And these are both pleasing to Allah. The person who's fasting and break the fast, then this he or she has fulfilled the order of Allah. And the woman who didn't fast because of the menstruation, and I'm specifically here about menstruation, because it really sometimes gets very hard on the woman, they will get the reward of obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. Keep saying this to yourself. Wholeheartedly, I'm waiting for Ramadan. Because, Ya Allah, this is the month that is much easier for me to obey you. Much easier for me to get close to you. Much easier for me to make my scale heavier. But the way is me. How much I am gonna get is me. Let us not be. There is, alhamdulillah, let's maybe I will move a little bit and then we'll go back to taqwa. There's three levels of fasting. And we all need to remember this. There is the fasting of the commoners, everybody. And that person, she or he, will stay away from food, drink, and marital relationship from this time to this time. That's everybody. That's the commoners. This fasting, I don't eat, I don't drink. This actually and no marital relationship from this time to this time, that actually will fulfill the requirement of the obligation. كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامِ صِيَام became obligation, that's the requirement. But that's level one. Then I need level two, and there's level three. So then there is the second one, صَوْمُ الْخَوَاسِ. It's the fasting of the special. The fasting of the special. Who wants to be special? Well, actually the answer, the question should be, who doesn't want to be special? We all in this life, all human beings, want to be unique, want to be recognized, want to be special, want to be different than other people in a good way, in the positive way. So the second, Sawmul Khawas, the fasting of the special. Who are they? Definitely fulfilled the first one. Definitely fulfilled the first one. Then the second, Sawm an kull maharim Allah. Fasting from anything that is disobedient to Allah. Fasting from everything that is disobedient from Allah. What is fasting? I stay away, I hold. So any disobedience of Allah, which is part of the taqwa, we just said it, I am going to be staying away from it. Meaning, I am not looking, I'm not using my eyes, and I am fasting in anything that is not pleasing to Allah. I'm not going to look at any haram. Well, somebody will say, well, especially for us living in the West, it's all around us. I will say, lower your gaze. Don't look at it. Unless you see it first time, and then lower your gaze. I'm not going to use my eyes in anything that will lead to disobedience of Allah. I am not going to use my ears in anything that is disobedient to Allah. I am not going to listen to anything. I want my fasting to be special. Wholeheartedly, I'm looking forward to Ya Ramadan, because I am going to be different this Ramadan. I am going to be level two. I am going to be of the special. So when I come to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Rabbi Ameen, with my fasting, and He's opening my book, I am going to be among the special, not the ordinary and the common, the commoner. My eyes will not look at haram, or see haram, or read haram, or post haram, anything that is unlawful. My ears will not listen to anything that is unlawful immediately. I was like, this is Ramadan. Two. Three. I am not going to say anything that is not pleasing to Allah. I am not going to say anything that is displeasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is one of the hardest ones. That's why he said, Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam, when someone come and curse you, say bad words to you, hold and say, inni sa'im, and say, I am fasting. My hands will not write, will not type, will not post anything that is displeasing to Allah. I want to be special. I want this Ramadan to be different. I want my fasting to be special. It's not going to be like everybody else. It will need work. It will need work. It will need me to do things I have not done it before. Or maybe I have done it a long time ago. So my ears, my eyes, my tongue, not say anything. My hands, my legs, where I'm going. Especially after futur. Now we eat, where I'm going to go with my feet. Level two. Level three is the highest. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us a moment of it. That's called the fasting of the special. And that's actually the fasting of the heart. The fasting of the heart. What does the fast of the heart mean? Subhanallah. When the heart fasts, Ya Rabbi, one day, Ya Allah. When the heart fasts from anything but Him, Subhanah. This is not my words, actually. Absolutely not my words. This is the scholars of the heart, scholars who work hard to get close to Allah. When my heart will not be occupied with the daily matter that we are occupied with in other times outside Ramadan. In Ramadan, my heart will be occupied with Him only, Subhanah, the one and only. So three levels. Let us all, everyone who's listening, let us not accept for 30 days our fasting will be level one. Just fast, don't eat, don't drink, no marital relationship. Once I break my fast, everything changes. That's the commoners. And nobody wants to be a commoner. We all want to be special, let alone special in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And number two, the special. And three, maybe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, by His generosity, will give us number three. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ التَّقْوَى. Another definition of taqwa. أَنْ يَجِدُكَ حَيْثُ أَمَرَكَ وَلَا يَجِدُكَ حَيْثُ نَهَاكَ. It's another definition of taqwa. That He subhanahu finds you where He wants you to be and does not find you where He doesn't want you to be. Second definition of taqwa, لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ, so you may attain taqwa. What is it, Ya Allah? What is this taqwa? It's not fear. It's not fear of Allah. Fear is khawf. This is Allah conscious. And practically, أَيَّجِدُكَ حَيْثُ أَمَرَكَ. He, subhanahu, finds me and you where He wants me to be. وَلَا يَجِدُكَ حَيْثُ نَهَاكَ. And He does not find me where He told me not to be. Let's do it one more time and we'll take practical examples. Taqwa, يَجِدُكَ حَيْثُ أَمَرَكَ. He will find me where He wants me to be. And does not find me, and does not find me in a place where He doesn't want me to be. Meaning, it's time for futur, time to break the fast. Where does He want me to? Where will He look for me? In a place that I am breaking my fast in halal. So time for Maghrib, meaning He's looking at me, subhanah, and He's expecting me, watching me, that I'm putting the date, or I'm drinking water, or I'm eating my futur. That's taqwa. And He will not find me not eating because I'm busy still working. Then I'm not a muttaqi at this moment. Again, I'm talking about moments, not in general, a'udhu billah, but in that moment. Because He was looking to see me, basically, eating. He didn't find me eating. That's not pleasing to Him. At that moment, I am not. It's a simple things. I'm not talking about major sins. I'm talking about general, because this is daily life. Dhuhr time. Time for dhuhr. Where does He want me? Standing in salah. That's taqwa. And He doesn't want me, or when He looks and He sees me on my phone texting, nothing urgent, or I'm scrolling through my social media, it's salah time, then that's not definition of taqwa. يَجِدُكَ حَيْثُ أَمَرَكَ. Fajr time, for those who live close to the masjid, especially for the men, and it's Ramadan. Let's say you work and you can't go every day. It's the weekend. Where does He want me to be? Absolutely in salah standing, let alone in the masjid. When He looks at me, how He will see when I am in the masjid praying fajr. And لَا يَجِدُكَ حَيْثُ نَهَاكَ. And He will not, you don't want Him to see me and you. May Allah protect us all sleeping. Sleeping. That's not taqwa. That's not لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. يَجِدُكَ حَيْثُ أَمَرَكَ. And you always have. This is why it's Allah conscious. Because the moment you are in, or I am in, the thought in my hand, in my head should be, where does He want me to be? What action I do that pleases Him? Not what I want and what I like and what everybody else is doing. That's not it. It has to be Him and Him only. Think through Him. Speak through Him. Don't speak through Him. Don't look through Him. Let's bring back Allah to our life. Not the casual way, but to bring Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the way He deserves, subhanahu. Befit Him. Befit Him. You know, when we love someone, we always think of them. When we love, when we have the feeling of love, we always think of that person we love. If we have the true love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that He's always in with us, with me, in me, thinking of Him. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. It may get hard. And we all see the second week of Ramadan, get tired, especially if you are not used to fasting. Again, life doesn't change. In majority of us living in the West, life doesn't change. You still work, you still do the same thing. You probably maybe on call in the night, and then for mothers, they have the children, they have to take care of them, maybe they are newborn, all these things, right? Remind yourself, that will help you in the path of taqwa in Ramadan. أَيَّامًا مَعْدُودَاتٍ. That's what he said, Subhana. Ayyaman ma'duda. It's few days, counted days. How many of us every year? And remember this, that when Ramadan starts, it's like, wow, there's a 30 days. And next thing is what? It's the last 10 days. Next thing is what? Night of Eid. And subhanAllah, we're praying Eid. As if it just came and left. Everyone say that. So when you feel tired, when you feel exhausted, when you feel the himma, the resolve is getting lower, get up and say, it's only a few days. أَيَّامًا مَعْدُودَاتٍ. Few days. Don't let shaitan, let us not let shaitan lure us, change us throughout these 30 days. And keep living. أَيَّامًا مَعْدُودَاتٍ. Few days. الصوم لي وأنا أجزي به. Fasting is for me, and I will reward Allah. Another thing in Ramadan, this is through Ramadan. And we talked about it last week in general. شهر رمضان, what? الذي أنزل فيه القرآن. Is the month of the Quran. There's so many names of Ramadan, by the way. One of the names, شهر القراء, شهر القرآن. The month of the Quran. Now, as I am picking up my Quran, and that's an act of worship, no doubt about it. I need to be لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. My picking up the Qur'an, reading the Qur'an, flipping the page, لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. So you may attain taqwa. What is that? Let us all, everyone, let us all not have the goal of reading Qur'an is when will I finish? When will I finish? When will I finish my khatma? Let us not be. That is not taqwa. That's literally Allah is watching me, seeing me, looking at His words, and my goal is just when I'm going to finish. Think of it this way. Allah is exalted from analogy, subhana. You wrote a book, a letter, a text, right? And you gave it to someone. And they are reading, and you're watching. And it's a long letter. Next thing, after 2 or 3 minutes, they fold it and says, read it. And you say, really? You didn't even spend 5 minutes? How you will feel? How will I feel? What I wrote is not very important. They're not focused on what I said. They focused on just the reading. Let us not have this relationship with the Quran in Ramadan. It is not about how many times I finish the Quran. It is not about how many pages I read a day. It's about glorifying the words of Allah. It's His words. That's why we always have to go back and connect everything with Him, subhanah. It is His words. It's the Quran. It's Hablullah al-Mateen. It's the strong rope with Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's Noor. It's Burhan, it's light, it's an evidence, mubin, clear. And you go through the whole names of the Quran. When you pick it up, لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. So you may attain taqwa. So you are Allah conscious. You are doing an act of worship based upon what He told me. And I need my reward. I want you my reward. And I know you will reward me, Ya Allah. So I can't pick it up casual and just read. There's always this question comes up. Is it finishing it or know the meaning? Finishing it, at least one, is the sunnah of Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam. That's what he did with Sayyidina Jibreel, except the last year before he passed away, alayhi salatu wasalam, he read it twice. He read it twice, reviewed it with Sayyidina Jibreel for twice. Can I do both? Can I read the Quran? Can I read the Quran and finish one part? And maybe from that part, I take a few verses and I spend more time to understand what Allah is telling me. I'll struggle, of course. But there is nothing comes easy in this life. No, we say it always in the United States. There's no free lunch in this country. Nobody does things for free. You have to pay for it. You have to work for it. You have to earn it. Let alone the pleasure of Allah, the Jannah of Allah. And the Jannah of Allah is very expensive. أَلَا إِنَّ سِلْعَةَ اللَّهِ غَالِيَةَ أَلَا إِنَّ سِلْعَةَ اللَّهِ الْجَنَّةَ What Allah has is very expensive. What Allah has is Jannah. Jannah. And Allah reminds us twice in the Quran, أَمْ حَسِبْتُمْ أَن تَدْخُلُوا الْجَنَّةَ Do you think you will enter Jannah? وَلَمَّا يَعْلَمِ اللَّهِ الَّذِينَ جَاهَدُوا مِنْكُمْ وَيَعْلَمَ الصَّابِرِينَ Do you think you will go to Jannah? And Allah will not see those, meaning those who struggle for Him and act with patience, with endurance. Do you think? Meaning to enter Jannah and the Jannah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, let alone Jannah al-Firdaus, the highest level, let alone seeing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's not easy. Two things I need. Jihad, strive, struggle, put work, hard work, and patience, and endurance, and perseverance. Perseverance, keep going. So when you pick up the Quran, لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ We're not going to forget this goal. We will not forget this goal. The goal is لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ I'll attain taqwa, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, help me. I'll come to dua. But let's work on the Quran first. I'll pick it up. My goal is taqwa. Well, I don't understand a word from the Arabic. Read it with taqwa. Read it with the struggle that you are struggling, and the goal is Allah will reward you. And then maybe you finish, bi-idhnillah, and then you pick one verse and try to understand the meaning. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ I'm not reading it, so I tell people I finished Quran 5 or 6 times or I finished my Quran. That's not the goal. That's not تَتَّقُونَ. And I'm not reading it just because it's Ramadan. Of course, I'm going to read Quran. Alhamdulillah. But that's not لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ I am seeing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, seeing me, reading His words. And looking for my reward, Ya Allah. And then He sees my struggle in it. He sees how difficult it is for me, Ya Allah, to read, especially for those who don't read Arabic. May Allah reward you all. Let alone those who doesn't understand, they're struggling. He sees it. Do you think He will let it go? Subhana? No. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ Third, which is integral part of Ramadan. Integral part of Ramadan. Subhanallah. Is dua, is supplication. Supplication, dua, asking Allah. And in case maybe you, some of you may know that or have noticed that, if you look at the verses of the Quran, the verses of fasting in Surah Al-Baqarah, from the verse one I just shared with you, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامِ till the end of the verses, talking about siyam, in between them, the famous verse about supplication. وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِ إِذَا دَعَانِ فَلْيَسْتَجِيبُوا لِي وَلْيُؤْمِنُوا بِي لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْشُدُونَ If they ask you about me, I am near, close. أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِ إِذَا دَعَانِ I respond to the one, to the caller who calls me. فَلْيَسْتَجِيبُوا لِي Let them respond. Meaning, let them do what I'm telling them. وَلْيُؤْمِنُوا Let them believe in me. Not only believe external. Believe and believe in everything He is going to give me. لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْشُدُونَ So they may get guided. They will be guided. Dua. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ I'm a muttaqi in my dua. What does that mean? I know Allah is hearing me. I have no doubt. I know He's listening. I know He will respond. In this affirmation, in this yaqeen, in this certainty that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is listening and He will respond to me. How he will respond, that's a different story. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he responds to my and your dua, doesn't mean necessary he will give me everything I want, or he will give it to me exactly the way I asked. No, because sometimes what maybe I am asking is not the best for me, and he is the only one who knows that. But don't you ever ask Allah and you are in doubt that he will not give it to you. Udu'u Allah wa antum muqinuna bil ijaba, as the Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam said, ask Allah and you are sure internally, you're so certain that he will respond. Either he will give you exactly the same as you asked, either he will remove harm from your life, or he will leave it, the reward, till the day of judgment and the hereafter. So the reason I'm making dua, لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ, because that's ta'a. Dua is an act of worship. الدُّعَاء هُوَ الْعِبَادَةِ. Supplication is the act of worship. So I'm asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even if I don't need anything, oh, and who doesn't need? Who doesn't not need? But I am first of all lifting my arms, crying to him, because that's something, act of worship. And he told me, the verse I just shared it with you, and I know he will reward me for the act of asking, not reward me giving me what I want. That also he will do, but mainly he will reward me. Look at the generosity of Allah. Subhana, subhana. And how much we don't know who is he, subhana. The fact I need him and I raised my hand, asking him, he will reward me for raising my hand. Ad-du'a huwa al-ibad. The fourth thing, these are the highlights of Ramadan in acts of worship. Fourth thing is salah. Let us not have the casual salah. As the hadith of Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam, the famous hadith of al-musi' fi salata, that sahabi who did not do his salah correctly, or he didn't do it properly, he said, salli fa innaka lam tusalli, irji' salli, irji' fa salli fa innaka lam tusalli, go back and pray. He didn't pray. What did he do? He just did it very quickly. What did he do? If you read the hadith, it's a very famous hadith. What did he do? Quickly. Because how do we know he did it quickly? Because when he came back the third time, said, Ya Rasulullah, this is what I know. I don't know any way else of praying. He said to him, and he explained, that when you say Allahu Akbar, take your time, stand, put your hands, and when you read, think of the reading. I mean, he didn't say this, but the point he was explaining to him, فَإِذَا طُمَأْنَنْتَ, when you reach a point in every action of salah, of serenity, take your time. This is the private moment with Allah. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ, I know Allah is seeing me, so when I say Allahu Akbar, and this actually will lead to ihsan, to excellence, I know he's seeing me. I know he's listening to me. And he is hearing me. And I know he will never let me down. And he will reward me. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ, in your act of salah. We need to start from today. But let alone throughout Ramadan. We should not be the casual. The imam is reading in Taraweeh and we are sitting checking our phone. We just finished 8 rak'at. Don't do that. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ is difficult. Let alone in the middle of Taraweeh, people pick up the phone and see who called. Let's just shut off the phone during Taraweeh, because my goal is not to see how many followers and who loves me or not, or who's calling me or not. My goal is لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ, so you may reach the taqwa, you may reach Allah conscious, you may have, Ya Rabbi Ameen, all of us, the level of those special fasting, let alone the special of the special. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us life to live to Ramadan. Ya Rabbi Ameen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us, Ya Rabbi, innaka ala kulli shay'in qadeer. Help us to not only fast, not only read Quran, not only make salah, not only make dua, not only be better human beings, but all of them, Ya Rabbi, in every act that pleases you, help us to do it in the best quality, Ya Rabbi, so we may reach at the end. What we all want to do is to reach the level of al-muttaqeen, Ya Rabbi, Ameen. We promised you that, Jazakumullah khair, everyone who is joining us. I see people are joining us from all over the world. Rabbi lak alhamd wal minna, almost every state here in the United States. I promised you I'll take some of the questions. We have very limited time left, but let's see what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will allow us. How do I soften my heart before Ramadan? I feel like I don't have enough khushu' in my prayer. I am unable to offer sunnah for rawatib prayer. Subhanallah. May Allah, Shaylain, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's a beautiful question. The question itself has a lot of khair in it. Don't despair from yourselves, my dear sisters and brothers. That question tells me this person, this Muslim, loves Allah and wants to get close to Allah. Because why we are asking, I don't have khushu'. Other person will have to say, well, alhamdulillah, I prayed. Yeah. This is what it is. How do I soften my heart? So the question actually has an answer. Is the reason I am not having khushu' is because my heart is hard. How do I soften my heart? That's another whole lecture, inshallah. But you can go back in our website and look at our tazkiyah, or on the YouTube and look at our tazkiyah. The types of the hearts and the process of purification. It's on our YouTube, Jannah Institute YouTube channel. But in general, stand long in salah. It's actually one of the righteous saints said that, إِذَا وَجَدْتَ قَسَاوَةً فِي قَلْبِكِ, if you feel your heart is hardened, فَأَطِلِ الْقِيَامِ, stand longer in salah, even if you don't know what you are saying. Meaning, it's the same verse I'm repeating. It's fine. In nafila salah, actually open the Quran and read from it. أَطِلِ الْقِيَامِ. Right? And if you are not yet, فَأَطِلِ الصِّيَامِ, you know, we are already fasting, that's good, alhamdulillah. And then it says, you know what? Touch the head of an orphan. Go and find an orphan and talk to them. But mainly, long salah alone. And Taraweeh is beautiful, but when we are in jama'ah, it's beautiful. The feeling is beyond. But if I still, after all this, with the Taraweeh, I'm still soft, my heart is not as soft as I am, is actually do longer salah alone. And what softens the heart is also a lot of istighfar. A lot of istighfar. Ask Allah for forgiveness. I don't know what I did. We don't know what we did. Allah only knows. And a lot of salah ala Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam. My father-in-law is non-Muslim. May Allah guide everybody. Will I be sinful if I cook for him in the daytime? No. On the contrary. No. The non-Muslims, who needs to fast? Fasting is an obligation upon al-Muslim, al-aqil, al-baligh. And al-muqeem, the Muslim person who has accepted Islam, and al-aqil adult, and al-aqil al-baligh al-adult. I'm sorry, al-aqil in a state of mind, and then muqeem, the person who is not a traveler, and add to it the woman who is not in a state of menstruation or bleeding after delivery. Your father-in-law is absolutely non-Muslim. On the contrary, look at it this way: when he knows you're fasting, and how difficult it is to cook, right? He knows you're fasting, but you are serving him. You're serving him. That may be, bi-idhnillah, and with a lot of your dua and your fasting, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide them. Guide him. Don't, لا تقنطوا من رحمة الله. Don't despair from the mercy of Allah. You never know. Many of the non-Muslims became Muslims by interaction with the Muslims, even these day and age. Subhanallah. Ameen. My first Ramadan, Allah, may Allah make it easy for you, Ya Robin. My first Ramadan, and I am a bit frustrated. Why? I've been trying to ask my doctor if it is safe for me to fast. I have still not received an answer. What should I do if I don't hear back in time? Call them. Maybe he doesn't know. Call a Muslim physician. I don't know where are you, but ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide you, number one. I always, when things doesn't get easy, I always turn to Allah. Ya Rabbi, you know, should I fast or not? Because you don't want to fast if it's going to harm you, and that's not pleasing to Allah. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. And you should fast if you have no bad sequence or harm happens to you because of the fasting. Try to find a Muslim physician. Google. Ask Allah. Ask Allah. Don't be frustrated. Frustration is from shaitan. Frustration from Satan, absolutely. Turn to Allah in your salah. Ya Rabbi, you know I want to fast. This is 3 days and 4 days. Please let them answer me. لا تيقنطوا لا تيأسوا من روح الله. Don't despair from the mercy of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. And may Allah سبحانه وتعالى make it easy for everybody. Allah سبحانه وتعالى is ever merciful. سبحانه most compassionate. سبحانه most generous. سبحانه He is pleased with anyone who makes dua and ask for his help. Alhamdulillah. Absolutely. Absolutely. Allah, remember this. I'm just giving you the meaning of the hadith. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, إِذَا لَمْ يُسْأَلْ يَغْضَبْ If he is not asked, he gets unhappy or angry, subhanahu, in the way befit him. When we don't ask him, ask him. Ask him, subhanahu. My question is, sometimes I feel guilty in asking Allah for things that I want, dunya things, and want to happen in me because it might appear I am not contented with what I have. La, why is that? This is another mean of shaitan, unless what you are asking, which I doubted, but unless what we are asking is not pleasing to Allah. So somebody wants children, why not? Of course, who's going to give me children except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And al-mal wal-banun, zinatul hayat al-dunya. Wealth and children is the beauty of this life. That's what Allah said in Surah Al-Kahf. But that doesn't mean I'm not going to ask for children. No. Alhamdulillah, and not only children, righteous children, more than one. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves it when he hears us asking him, as long as what we are asking is not displeasing to him. So don't let shaitan do this. Having said that, don't focus in your dua only on the dunya matter. That's something we all have to remember. Meaning, I need to have the balance of dunya and akhirah, the hereafter and this life. So I need to ask Allah, focus in your dua. Ya Allah, give me Jannah. Ya Allah, give me husnul khatima. Ya Allah, give me a good end. Ya Allah, make my grave a piece of Jannah. Ya Allah, yassir hisabi. Ya Allah, makes you taking me accountable, make it easy. Ya Allah, give me Jannah al-Firdaus. Ya Allah, don't deprive me from not seeing you. All these of the dunya. Ya Allah, improve my manners. Ya Allah, bring me closer to you. This all of akhirah. But at the same time, Ya Allah, if somebody is not married, Ya Allah, give me a righteous spouse. If you are married and your spouse is not, you want your spouse to improve. Ya Allah, improve my spouse. Ya Allah, make him or her righteous people. So there is nothing wrong with asking of dunya matter as long as we don't forget the akhirah. We'll take one more because it's 1 minute. Okay, I wanted to do Umrah with a group, but it didn't work. قَدَّرَ اللَّهُ مَا شَاءَ فَعَلْ That's how we say. Allah decree, and whatever Allah decree happens. I'm sad. But it was the result of doing istikhara. Alhamdulillah, then why you are sad? He didn't want you to go for a good reason. Will Allah give me the reward of my good intention doing the Umrah during the Ramadan? نعم, نعم. The intention is extremely important. He knows you wanted to go. And to answer this, Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam, he came back from Ghazwat Tabuk. This is the Ghazwat it was a very hard expedition. And some of the Sahaba were left in Medina. They didn't go out. Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam gave them the excuse. Simply, they didn't have the means to go out with him. They had no money. They had nothing to ride to go with him. And he said, as he came back, expedition. And he said to the Sahaba that with him, there are people in Medina, stayed in Medina. You did not go down a valley or you went up on an uphill, but they will get the reward, the same reward that you got. They said, Ya Rasulallah, but they were in Medina. They didn't come without. He said, حَبَسَهُمُ الْعُذُرُ The reason they did not go out, because of a valid excuse. A valid excuse. You prayed istikhara, Allah didn't open it. Alhamdulillah. Allah, inshallah, will give you. Jazakumullahu khayran. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you all for trusting us. MashaAllah, tabarakallah, the good turnout today and from all over the world. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you life, everybody, to get to Ramadan, give you the best Ramadan. Don't forget to pray to each other. Pray for your children, pray for yourself, pray for your family, but pray for the ummah, pray for the Muslims, that Allah bring us all back to him. Subhanallah, with a beautiful return. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Sallallahu ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa ashabi taslima kathira. No more Tuesday program, the month of Ramadan. Alhamdulillah. Follow us on our social media. We have programs for you. Inshallah, it will benefit everybody. Jazakumullahu khayran. Assalamu alaikum.